In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a Broadlink RM Pro in Home Assistant. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech. And today we're going to be using a Broadlink RM Pro to control both IR and RF devices straight from Home Assistant. So let's get going. The Broadlink RM Pro is a great way to interface with cheaper smart tech using RF commands rather than going over Wi-Fi. You can also interface with your entertainment system using IR to replace your TV remote. Now that Paul Hibbert has dived into the world of Home Assistant, I thought this might help him out a little bit setting it up. This process definitely isn't as easy as setting up other integrations in Home Assistant, because you're going to have to learn each command individually. If you've already set up your Broadlink and you're using the eControl app, there is a way to extract that information to save you a bit of time, but that does involve needing Android or Windows to do it, and I don't have either of those, so I'm going to show you today how to set everything up from scratch. The first thing you need to do is set up your Broadlink device in the eControl app. This is so you can connect your device to the Wi-Fi. If you're using one of the newer devices, you need to make sure you're not connecting it to the cloud. Just connect to the Wi-Fi and leave it there. Once it's connected, you can use the app to access the MAC address of your device. You'll then need to go into your router settings and give it a static IP address so Home Assistant can interface with it. Once that's done, we can move over to Home Assistant. What we're going to need to do is add the Broadlink to our main configuration file. We're going to add it as a remote under the platform Broadlink. We need to add the host IP address, the MAC address, and then we can give it a name if we want to. Once that's done, we save, we check our config, and we restart Home Assistant. If all's gone to plan so far, under the Developers tab, we can see that our new remote has been listed. Now we can move on to learning the commands. This process is quite tedious because you've got to learn each command individually, but it's worth it in the end. We can head over to the Services tab and use the service Remote Learn command. In here, we need to add our entity ID, the device name, and the command name. So I'm going to use the test division as my device name, and then I'm going to add the command, which is the button I'm going to press on these remotes. Once you've entered the information, press Call Service, and then you can point your remote at the RM Pro, and it will learn the command. Once you press Call Service, you will get a notification telling you to point the remote at the RM Pro and press the command. And then once it's learnt the command, then the notification will disappear. You can then move on to the next one. We just need to rename the command and then press Call Service again. And we rinse and repeat for all the commands we want to learn on our remote. Now that we've learnt all the commands, we need to find them so we can do something with them in Home Assistant. You'll find them if you go over to your file editor in the .storage folder. In this folder, you should see a file called Broadlink underscore remote. It'll then have the MAC address of your Broadlink device listed afterwards. So if you have multiple Broadlink devices, all the commands will be separated per which one you learnt the device from. Inside here, you'll see a list of all the commands that you've learnt. We can now open a new window, go back to our file editor and add some switches. As usual, mine are referenced in a separate file, so we'll open that up now. We're going to add new switches under the platform Broadlink using the host IP address and MAC address, and then we write switches. Each switch has a name, a friendly name, and a command on. If your switch also has a command off, which is separate to your command on, then you can list it separately here. For example, if your power plug has an on and an off switch separately, or your TV has an on and an off switch separately. The command on is actually the code that was listed in the other document. So we want to copy it from the other document into here. We want to make sure we're including the quote marks, but excluding any commas that might exist between lines. We rinse and repeat for all the switches that we need to make. Once you've done all that, you should have a long document with all the switches that you've learnt. If you're happy, click Save, check your config, and restart Home Assistant. We can then head over to the Developers tab, and we can see that all our new switches are listed. If we click on them, we can trigger it, and it should emit the IR pulse from our Broadlink and control whichever device it's meant to. Now we can move on to the RF. Again, this is quite complicated, but when you get into it, it's not too bad. We're going to need the eControl app to make this work. But before we do that, we're going to set up our call service. This is the same command as before, so if we head over to our call service tab, the service is remote.learn_command, then our entity is our RM Pro, we add our device and our command name. I'm using some RF plugs for this, so my commands are going to be on and off. But make sure you don't press call service yet, we're just setting it up for now. Now we can head over to our eControl app. We're going to add a new remote, select our Broadlink RM Pro, and then choose an RF socket. In here, you can see a list of buttons that we're going to program in a minute. The first one we're going to use is plug one, or socket one, and the on one. So we click on that, and then it asks us to sweep frequency. We click sweep frequency, and then we hold down the button on our remote. Once it's swept the frequency, it'll tell you that it's swept, and then you need to click OK. But don't press the button on the remote again yet. Before you press the button on the remote, we're going to press call service back in Home Assistant. Once you press call service, you should get a little notification telling you to press the button on the remote. This is now when you can press it. Once the remote has been recognised by the Broadlink, you should get a notification on your eControl app saying saved successfully, and the notification in Home Assistant should disappear. Once that's happened, we can move on to the next button. We can just repeat the process for all our other buttons, making sure you change the device and command in your call service, otherwise you'll overwrite previous codes. It's very simple. We click on the new button in the app, press sweep frequency, hold the button down on our remote. It should sweep all the frequencies. Once the frequencies are swept in the app, then you click done. And before you hold down the button again, you go back over to Home Assistant, press call service. The notification should appear in Home Assistant, and then you can press the button on your remote. This should be recognised in Home Assistant and the app. In the app it will say saved successfully, and in Home Assistant the notification will disappear. Once you've done this for all your buttons, we're going to need to open up our file editor again. Again, use two windows. In the first window, we're going to open up our Broadlink codes. So they're in the .storage folder, and then the file is named Broadlink Remote, and then it's got the MAC address codes. If you open this up, you should see your new RF codes have appeared. In your other file editor window, you're going to open up your switches, either in a separate switches file or in your main configuration file. In our switches file, we add new switches as we did last time, giving them a name, a friendly name, a command on, and a command off, if relevant. And then we go back to our codes file and we copy the codes from our new devices, and then we can paste them in our switches file. Remember to include the speech marks, but not any commas. Once that's done, and we're happy we've done all of our codes, we can save, check our config, and restart Home Assistant. Once Home Assistant has fully restarted, we can see our new integrations. If we head over to the States in the Developers tab, then we can search for our switches. As you can see, mine are all listed here. If you click on them, let them load a little bit, and then you can power them on and off using the two separate commands. If that all works, then we're fully integrated. So there we go. We can control both IR and RF devices from inside Home Assistant. Make sure you hit subscribe and click the bell icon below so you don't miss out on future videos about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.